So now I would like to talk a little bit about industrial controls and how the evolution on the industrial controls has changed the world. So we know for a fact, like also mentioned here, that the industrial controls world will keep on evolving also in the years to come here. But in order to understand what this means for our sensors or for the sensor world and how we can create new values, new opportunities, make life smarter, we need to also to understand the industrial revolution. Because sensors has been around for many, many decades, actually, and they have somehow always been a part of, or you could say that they have been linked, the evolution on the sensor side has been linked to the evolution on the industrial control side as well. And like I said, the step from industry 3.0 to 4.0, this is where the term smart sensor starts to appear. And this is like the key topic on the sensor side, actually, for the industrial fourth industrial revolution. So let's now take a closer look on, because in order to understand the future, we kind of need to take a look on maybe the present, or maybe even say, so why do we have industrial controls at all? So how does all this, did all this start? Looking on the industry 3.0, I would like to look into some of the core elements of this industry 3.0 ecosystem, and then also why we actually got to the point where we introduced this. So here, just briefly showing some of the important enablers here or parts of the ecosystem. So embedded controllers, that's definitely the key element here, right? So introducing PLCs, the capability to start to control stuff and to automate stuff. Electronical sensors as a part of the solution, of course, because at the end of the day, our embedded controllers, they need to be fed with real-time data, important physical events that happen on the application that needs to be taken into account in the control loop. Gateways here, in this case here, rather simpler gateways, which allow the PLCs to have communication to local computers. Of course, software is an important element here, because at the end of the day, there needs to be algorithms that will run the control of the different applications. And then also an important one, the human machine interface here. So basically going away from very rigid panels and push button setups and relays that are very hard to reconfigure very rigid. We can go for much more visualized solutions to make the interface easier, to switch in between different user profiles and so on. Okay, but why did we introduce all of this? Here the question would be to control stuff, right? And more actually to automate stuff, to get rid of a lot of manual processes that are hard to control and that are hard to optimize on. So process optimization was really one of the drivers of embedding controls here in applications. And then also safety, of course. So going for an automated solution on the control side is actually also leading to new ways to ensure that you have a safe environment around your whatever application you are controlling here. Switching to industry 4.0. So looking on the what's and why's of the industry 3.0, and knowing where we are today, the very important piece missing here is definitely the data collection. And this is like a very, very crucial part of the industry 4.0. Looking on the what's here, you can see that, of course, we still have PLCs.
Dennis, sorry, we have a question coming in it is from Sweden. So just one second, sorry. Mm-hmm. Were data collection not part of the industry 3.0 at all?
Okay. Of course, you cannot say it was not part of it at all, but at least initially it was not part of the plan. That was not what they were looking for. But on the fly, they learned that this was actually also of relevance and that collecting data could be interesting for the solution. This is how we actually slowly also entered the industry 4.0. But yes, data were collected, but then more in a manual manner. So shard recorders, sneakerware and stuff like that.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, thanks.
But now it's basically like a crucial part of the ecosystem for the industry 4.0.
Yes.
So in having all the computational power, like I just mentioned here, so still the PLCs, you now also have data collection as a crucial part. So the whole data handling ecosystem is a part of it.
Yeah.
And that's what you can see here. So you have PLCs, you have sensors, even more sophisticated sensors now, because we are collecting much more data. Gateways are now not only to local computers, but now also gateways to different networks, to the internet, gateways to different machine environments, so machine-to-machine interfaces, big computers, mainframes that can handle data that is collected and then squeezing out valuable information on-site, SCADA systems, so remote access to data that has been stored in a cloud environment. And then a very, very crucial and important element, of course, the whole data analytics. Because now data is only interesting if you can use it to squeeze out valuable information that you can use to optimize your processes or increase the efficiency in what you're doing. Yep. And here I have...
And also, I just want to remind all of you, because we've got some great questions coming in, and it's really great. So please keep them coming. So don't hold back if you have any questions to Dennis. Sorry to interrupt you, Dennis.
Yeah, no problem. I'm also keen on getting questions, so for sure. Data analytics, so I also put in here machine learning and AI, so really advanced analytics we are talking about here. But that's also something that the evolution on the control side, so we have very powerful microcontrollers now and computers, and this is also allowing us basically to go for very advanced analytics that will really also shape the future of tomorrow. And again, what kind of data needs to be fed into those machine learning and AI algorithms? We can guess, but for sure, they will be able to handle a lot of information. So that is also why sensors are really a key element here also to get more know-how, to get more data you can use, more historical data to use in order to say something about your system. So again, why still to automate? We are still very interested in having a safe environment. And process optimization, but the keyword actually here, that's efficiency. So to capture increased efficiency, that's one of the keywords of industry 4.0. And basically you could say to do more with less. So this is what you want to do by adding the data.